This film's an incredibly exciting film to work on. The process is great. We have an enormous amount to build. There are so many different locations and environments in the story. The bulk of the film is a solid, old-fashioned construction. It's what we'd call build heavy. We've built sets on stages that we've turned over 3, 4, 5, 6 times. And every layer just makes it kind of closer and closer to the vision. A big advantage has been that we've been able to build a great deal and really make the film look like the graphic novel. The significant sets are Manhattan's lab, which is in a military base there, and his apartment. This set is the jail cell, Rorschach's jail cell, and the actual prison that he comes into. When we came through first, none of this was here. Really, the only thing that was here was this hole in the roof above. When I was walking through here, it struck me that really that look is all to do with that split level, you know, that double, triple, quadruple level that you get in a jail. The narrowness really helped us. There's enough existing location here that we were able to add bars, add a couple of walls, but generally we've contained this in a very kind of tight little set. Blake's apartment, we imagine this kind of 1980s bachelor pad. He doesn't have much taste and it's very kind of glittery and ostentatious. Hopefully reflects his character fairly accurately. Hollis Mason's around the corner. That was a location that we did a full build on the interior and built the exterior to make it resemble this environment. And then the real significant one is Karnak, which is in Antarctica, and we're building that on Big Stage 6.
Welcome to New York.
Well, we're in New York, 1985. This is really the hub of Watchmen world. We've got this tiny little space that we've carved out of New York in that period of 1985. It sort of centers around 43rd Street and 6th Avenue. We're right in that middle, Times Square. 1985, very seedy, very down, kind of realistic, but with our own kind of Watchmen overtone. It's really important for us to establish a world that is real to an audience. It absolutely remains faithful to the vision of the graphic novel, and building by building, you go through and you build a layer, let it sit, let it age, let the rain hit it for a little while, then come back and do another layer. Some of the stuff we've had to do in 2 days, 1 day, you know, 3 hours, we have to find ways of accelerating. There's also layers and layers of graffiti in the graphic novel. The more you look at the graphic novel, the more there is there.
This is the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. I want to move it.
You're joined right over here.
Everyone on my crew, the painters, the artists, the graphic designers, the prop masters, they've all taken a huge amount of time studying the graphic novel. It's helped enormously to add texture to this kind of Watchmen world. So it's definitely a kind of mix of looking at real location reference from the time and then adding in this layer that the graphic novel frames help to kind of cement into this very specific Watchmen kind of bubble.